experimentation of the broadside linear array with the uniform spacing and the amplitude. Actually, this is related to the practical, and in this practical, it is required to make the MATLAB simulation of the MATLAB using the MATLAB. So for that one, this we are going to see. Actually, with the antenna, we have seen or we have come across the various parameters of the antenna, and in that one, we have concerned about the directivity of the antenna. What is the directivity of the antenna? The directivity, it is nothing but the ratio, that is the radiation density in a particular direction divided by the average radiation density. That is the one of the definition. Now, what happens with the antenna array, or why there is a need for the antenna array, that can be seen here. The radiation pattern of the single element, it is relatively wide, and each element, it provides the low directivity. So in many applications, the antennas, they require the very large directive characteristics to meet the demands of the long distance communication. Somebody wants to join? Yes. So here we are going to see that when we are going to consider the directivity, that time it is required to consider the radiation pattern. And we have seen that with the directivity or the radiation pattern of the antenna, with the directional antenna, the radiation pattern, it is more wide, and it is required that the directivity should be high, means the radiation pattern should be very narrow. So therefore, if you are using the single element, that is the dipole antenna, Yagi antenna, like this, if you are making the use of the single element, then it is going to provide the low directivity, means the radiation pattern, it is more wide. So therefore, it is required that the directive, in order to get the higher directivity, the radiation pattern should be more narrow. Because in the particular applications, we require the highly directive characteristics, and this will be going to cover the long distance communication. So how the antenna, it is then array, it is then formed? The antenna formed by the multiple elements, it is referred to the antenna array. So we are going to consider connect the number of the elements, and that is we are going to call it as an antenna array. So this antenna array, it is of the linear array type, and in that one we are going to see if the antenna elements are equally spaced along the straight line, then we will be going to call it as a linear array. So therefore, in our this particular MATLAB simulation, we are going to consider the broadside array. This is the one of the type of the antenna array, and its schematic and its radiation pattern, it is then shown in this figure. So this broadside array, it is the one in which the number of the identical parallel antennas, they are set up along the line drawn perpendicular to their respective axis as shown in the figure. So you can see here, this is the arrangement for the broadside array, and in which we are going to see that these parallel elements are there, like this one, just a minute. So these all are the parallel elements, and they are connected in a such a way that the distance between these elements, it is then kept D, or the distance between the elements, it is going to be fixed. So therefore, in this one, we are going to see that the number of the elements, that is the number of the parallel elements, they are set up along the line which is drawn perpendicular to their respective axis. So therefore, here it is we can see the line. Here it is the line which is drawn perpendicular to the axis. These are the axis, and the line which is drawn perpendicular to this one. So therefore, this is how we are going to consider or construct the broadside array. And in this broadside array, the number of the parallel elements are there, and the distance between these elements, it is fixed. And with such type of the antenna, the radiation pattern which you are getting, it is then shown like this one. So it is required that this radiation pattern which is we are obtained here, it should be more narrow. Presently, we are going to see that this radiation pattern, it is wide, and with the elements, with the number of the elements and with the spacing between the elements, it is required to adjust this radiation pattern in a such a way that the radiation pattern will be more narrow. So if it is obtained, that means more directivity will be obtained. So that is what our aim. So therefore, in this broadside array, The individual antennas are equally spaced along the line, and each element it is then paired with the equal magnitude, which are all in same phase. This arrangement fires the broadside directions, that is perpendicular to the line of the axis, that is line of the array axis, and there will be the more or the maximum radiations, and there will be relatively little radiations in the another direction. So if you are going to see that, the more radiation will be there on this one, that is we are going to call it as a major lobes, and the smaller radiations which are there on the this axis, that is the we are going to call them as side lobes. So the radiation pattern of the broadside array, which is a bidirectional, and it is then shown in the figure, and it is going to radiate equally well in either direction of the maximum radiation. So we can see this particular radiation pattern. So therefore, this radiation pattern, it is bidirectional. It is going to radiate in both the direction, and it is going to make equally radiation in equally it is equally radiation in both the direction, and that is what the concept related to the broadside array. Now what we are going to do, we are going to perform the MATLAB experimentation for this broadside array. So now I am going to stop this particular screen sharing, and I am going to open the window in which the MATLAB program or the MATLAB code is there, and that we are going to do it here. So therefore, I am going to present the screen, the another screen that I am going to present here, and in this screen where we are going to see now the MATLAB code. Yes. So therefore, this particular screen, it might be visible on your mobile screen, and there will be going to see that I have opened the program, or I have opened the MATLAB, and this MATLAB in which the code, that is MATLAB code for the broadside array, this is the broadside array for which the code it is there. So in this code, if you are going to see here, the statements are given here, and according to this, the program is to be run. So that is the running of the program, it should be done. So regarding the code in which you are going to see what are the steps in that one, if you will be going to run running of this program, the code, it can be understood. Instead of explaining the statement one by one, if you'll be going to run the code in that one, it is better to understand these things. So therefore, I am going to run this particular program or this particular code. And so therefore, just a minute. So we'll now run this code. So therefore, there is a button which is run. So I have run this program, and you can see here the command window. In this command window, it is asking to enter the operating frequency. In the operating frequency, we are going to consider the very high frequency, that is 3 into 10 raised to 8 hertz. So therefore, I am going to write 3 to the power, that is 10 to the power, that is for writing this one, 3 E8. So therefore, the meaning of this one is that 3 into 10 raised to 8 hertz, that will be then written in this one. What is the meaning of E? E, it is nothing but the 10 to the power, or 10 raised to something. So therefore, 10 raised to 8, it is the 3 into 10 raised to 8 hertz. This is the frequency. After this, I am going to press it here, enter. Then it is asking to give the enter the number of the elements. As you have seen just now, the construction of the broadside array in which the number of the parallel elements are there. So therefore, what will be the effect of increasing the number of the elements that you will be seeing the first? So what I will do, the number of the elements which are required, say it is 5. So therefore, the number of the elements which are there, that is I am entering it as a 5. So then it is going to calculate the lambda. What is the formula for the calculation of the lambda? For calculation of the lambda, we need this one, that is lambda is equal to C by F. That is, C is the velocity of the light, which is 3 into 10 raised to 8 divided by the frequency. So therefore, what you have taken, the frequency is also 3 into 10 raised to 8, and the velocity of the light, it is also 3 into 10 raised to 8. So therefore, numerator and the denominator both are same, so hence we'll be getting this ratio, that is lambda is equal to 1, because the lambda is equal to c upon f, where c is the velocity of the light, which is 3 into 10 raised to 8, and the operating frequency that we have chosen, the operating frequency we have chosen, it is also 3 into a raised to 8, means 3 into 10 raised to 8. So hence we are going to see that the ratio that is we are getting here, it is 1, and so therefore lambda is equal to 1. After that, again I am going to enter here. It is then asking here, just a minute, there is an error in this program. So the error what has occurred here, matrix dimensions must agree. So let us run this program again. What I will do, please enter the operating frequency. So therefore 3 e raised to this we have done. Then enter the number of the elements. The number of the elements are 5. We have got lambda is equal to 1. Then they are asking to enter the distance between the elements. So let us take the distance between the elements, that is 25 centimeter, which is 0.25 meters. So therefore I have taken it here. Then after this after running this program, we will be getting this figure. Now what we are going to understand from this figure, that is we have to see here. In this one, we will be going to get the radiation pattern. The radiation pattern, which is what? It is nothing but the field intensity, the electric field intensity, which is then plotted in the two forms. The first one, it is there, which is in the linear scale. This one, it is there, which is in the linear scale. And the other one, it is there, which is in the dB scale. So we can see here, this is the polar pattern in which the angles are mentioned 0, 30, 40, 0, 30, 60, 90, like this one, the angles are there. And we are going to see that this radiation pattern, which we have obtained with the broadside array by taking the number of the elements 5. We have taken the number of elements 5 and the pattern which we have got it like this one. So here, this is the radiation pattern. And we are going to see that the radiation pattern which is obtained here, it is comparatively wide. What is our requirement? The radiation pattern should be more narrow. So therefore, this is what we have obtained, that is in the linear scale, and this is in the decibel scale. That is, we are going to consider it is a decibel scale. Now further, in this one, we are going to see, that is the parameters which we have obtained. We have seen the performance parameters, in which the parameters which we have considered, just we can focus on this one. Here we are going to see that the lambda, we have got it here, and from this one, the HPBW, you can see here, this particular parameter, HPBW, which is nothing but the half power beam width. So how to get the half power beam width? Regarding this, already we have considered that half power beam width, it is nothing but the angle at which the electric field intensity, it is decreasing to 70% of its maximum value. So you can see here, it is the maximum value, it is 1 at this point. And wherever the field intensity is falling to 70% of maximum value, that is we are going to call it as the HPBW, or the half power beam width. So therefore, computation of this one, it is done through this formula, and the answer for this one we have got, it is 41.49. So means we have got the beam width, that is the half power beam width, which is 41.49 with the broadside array by taking the 5 elements. It is required that in order to get the more directivity, the HPBW, that is the half power beam width, should go on decreasing. So let us do what? We'll be now going to make again the running of this program. And in that one, instead of taking the 5 elements, let us take now 10 elements. So therefore, I am going to run the program again. Again, the same process will be there. Firstly, we have to enter the operating frequency, which is 3E8, means 3 into 10 raised to 8. Then we have to enter the number of the elements. In the first case, we have taken the 5 elements. Now we'll take the 10 elements. So enter here. Now the distance between the lambda they have obtained, it is equal to 1, because C by F, it is 1. And the number distance between this one, the distance that I'm going to keep fixed, that is 0.25 meters. So therefore, this distance, it is now fixed. Then we are going to get, after running the program, we'll find out this figure. Now compare Now we can compare. In the previous case, the radiation pattern which you obtained and the now the radiation pattern which you are getting, we can guess the difference, or we can check the difference. There we'll find out that in this second case, with the number of the elements is equal to 10, the radiation pattern it is getting more narrow as compared to the previous case. The previous figure it is not seen over here now, but here we can see that the radiation pattern which is the more narrow, and this is in the linear scale and this is in the decibel scale. What we are going to find out that it is required that the beam width, that is the half power beam width which is there, it should decrease here. So therefore I can see here now the half power beam width which you are getting in the previous case, how much it was obtained? In the previous case it was obtained 41.49 degrees. Now the half power beam width we are getting here, it is 20.4027. So means the beam width it decreases, it means the beam gets more narrow, and which means the more directivity. So that is what the thing we have to observe. Now here let us take one more case, that is how many elements we have considered. Firstly we have considered 5 elements, then we are going to consider the 10 elements, now we'll consider the 20 elements. So therefore let us run the program again. Again the same process will be there. Firstly we have to enter the frequency, that is 3E8, that is the frequency. The number of the elements now I am going to increase 20. So therefore by increasing the number of the elements, that is 20, the lambda you are getting again same, that is 1. The distance that between the elements again I am going to fix, which is 0.25 meters. So sorry, 0.25 meters, that is this distance. Now entering this value, the simulation will take place. Observe this radiation pattern. You'll find out that as compared to the previous two, the radiation pattern it is getting more narrow. So this can be seen from this here. This can be seen from this also. That is the half power beam width. Now we are getting here it is only 10.1608. So from this also we can conclude that the half power beam width it decreases, means the beam it gets more narrow, and so therefore, just a minute. So beam it gets more narrow, which can be then observed like this one. So what we have done in this particular program, that we have considered the broadside array, and in this broadside elements we have varied the number of the elements. Firstly we have taken 5, then we have taken 10, then we have taken the 20. From that one we have seen the normalized E field pattern, that is the field pattern or the radiation pattern, and it is our observation that by increasing the number of the elements, the radiation pattern it is going to be more directive. That means the radiation pattern it becomes more narrow. So if it is more narrow, that means we'll be getting the long distance communication. So this is our first part. In this first part, what you have seen that by increasing the number of elements, what will be the effect upon the radiation pattern or on the half power beam width that you have considered. Now in the second case, what we'll do, we'll be going to keep the number of the elements fixed. Instead of that, now we'll be going to vary the distance between the elements. So by varying the distance between the elements, what will be the effect on the half power beam width, or what will be the effect on the radiation pattern that we have to observe. So what I will do, again I am going to run this program. After running this program, firstly we have to enter the operating frequency. So entering the operating frequency, 3 into 10 raised to 8, that is the operating frequency. Then we have to enter the number of the elements. What we'll do, the number of elements now we are going to keep fixed. So let us consider the number of elements will be 10. So that I'm going to keep it as a 10. Then we have to get the lambda. Lambda is equal to C upon F, which is equal to 1. Then in this case, now we are going to make the variation of the distance between the elements. So let us consider the distance between the this one, 0.5 meter. We have to vary the distance between the elements. So therefore, what I will do, we'll keep the distance between the elements as 0.50 meters. So therefore, by keeping this one, we'll be getting this radiation pattern. So here, this radiation pattern which we are getting here from this one, we are going to observe that the radiation pattern it is we are getting, it is more directive. The beam will be more directive. And here the half power beam width, how much is the half power beam width that you can get it here? HPBW, it is we are getting how much? 10.16, that is we are getting here. In the second part, in the second case, now what we'll do, again we will keep the number of elements same, and what we'll do, we'll increase the distance between the elements. In the first case we have taken now 0.5, so in the second case now I'm going to take this distance 1 meter. So let us run the program first. So entering the operating frequency, which is 3e into 10^8, then number of the elements, number of elements I am going to keep fixed, that is number of elements are 10, and then the value of the lambda, it is obtained 1. Now we are going to enter the distance. In the first previous case we have taken the distance 0.5 meter. Now I am going to keep this distance 1 meter. So by entering 1, this is how the radiation pattern, you can observe very this one, that the radiation pattern which is obtained here, it is getting more narrow, which is we are going to get it more narrow in this particular case. So therefore we can then conclude here that by increasing the distance between the number of elements, we are getting the more directive pattern, or the radiation pattern, it gets more narrow. So in this one, further we are going to observe that along with the this half power beam width, the half power beam width which you have got it in the previous case with distance of 0.5 meter, it was 10.16. now here we are getting the half power beam width, it is 5.0754. so means the half power beam width, it decreases and the radiation pattern, it becomes more narrow. In addition to this HPBW, there are two more terms. The first term we are going to consider, it is FSLBW. The meaning of this one, it is F means first, S means that is side lobe. So first side lobe beam width, that is also find out. If you consider here the radiation pattern, what is the first side lobe? Here the side lobes, which you can see here particularly in the second figure. We are going to see here, this is the major lobe, this is also the major lobe, and these are the small lobes which are those are seen, those we are going to call it as a side lobes. So we can see that the side lobe, first side lobe, the first side lobe can be considered which is adjacent to the main side lobe. So therefore the main side lobe, it is here, and in adjacent to this one there is a small, this side lobe is there. So therefore this is the first side lobe, and the beam width for that one, it is also found out. So there is again the mathematical formulas for that one, and that is we have calculated is 17.25 degrees. Similarly, one more this parameter that is we are going to consider here, that is FNBW, which means first null beam width. Again you can see this particular figure, you can see here the what is the null beam width, that is the radiation, if there is no radiation along the particular axis, that is we are going to call it as a null pattern. Suppose we are going to consider this angle, suppose we are going to consider here the angle 60 degree, or if you are going to consider in this case it is 30 degree. So in this case there is no radiation, there is no radiation along this one. So therefore these lines which is shown like this one, or these lines which is shown like this one, where there is no radiation, that is we are going to call it as a null pattern, or the null null pattern. So here first null beam width, so here if this is here the major lobe, and in adjacent to this one, at this point there is a null, or at this a null pattern. So therefore the first null beam width, that is the distance between the major lobe and the first null, that is we are going to call it as a first null beam width, that is also found out by using the mathematical formula, and that we have got it here like this one. So the remaining parameters which are there, that is not of that much important. Our main concern is with the broadside array, is we have to see what is the effect of the variation of the number of the elements on the directivity of the antenna, or what is the effect of the increasing of the distance between the elements on the directivity of the antenna, that is of our main concern. So therefore these things that we have to consider, and from that one we'll be going to switch it again to our PPT, and there we have done the made the conclusion. So this PPT, which is related to the conclusion, whatever we have done the simulation or whatever we have done the experimentation, what are the conclusions we have got, for that one I am going to make the sharing of the PPT. So therefore this screen sharing will be, somebody wants to join? Yes. So therefore I am going to make the stop sharing for this one. Now again I am going to make the presenting of the screen, in which we'll be going to make the presentation of the PPT here. Now this particular PPT, which is there, in which there is written that observation table, the observation table, it is visible to you. And in this one, whatever in this observation table, whatever we have done the experimentation, this I have done in the form of the observation table. We have done the two cases. What the two cases we have studied? Firstly, we have increased the distance between, firstly we have increased the number of the elements. So here it is the our observation table. In this one, this is here the serial frequency number, operating frequency that we have kept constant. The operating frequency, that is, we have kept 3 into 10 raised to 8, that is 3e plus 8. So therefore operating frequency is kept constant, from which the lambda is equal to c upon f, that is also remaining constant. We have varied the number of elements. In the first case, we have taken the number of elements 5, and by keeping the distance between the elements fixed, that is 0.25 meter for all the cases, then we have got the radiation pattern, for which the half power beam width, that is, we have got, it is 41.49. So that is the half power beam width, that is, we have got it here. Then in the second case, we have increased the number of elements to 10, and the distance again we have kept the same, and the half power beam width, that is, we are getting 20.4. So as compared to the first case, the half power beam width decreases, it means the radiation pattern, it gets more narrow, that means directivity will be more. In the third case, we have increased the number of the elements to 20, and the distance again it is kept constant, and the half power beam width, that is, again we are getting decreases, that is 10.16. So here from this observation table, that by increasing the number of elements, the half power beam width decreases, which means the radiation pattern, it becomes more narrow, and the directivity, it gets more increased. This is our first case. Now in the second part, we have increased the distance between the elements. By increasing the distance d of the elements in the array, we have kept the number of elements 10. We have kept the number of the elements constant. So therefore, by keeping the number of elements constant, the distance between the distance between the elements, it is then increased. In the first case, we have kept 0.5 meters. The half power beam width, we have got 10.16. In the second part, this is, we have made the number of elements, that is again constant, and the distance is 1 meter. So half power beam width, it is 5.075. So hence we will find out that again this will decreases, and finally we'll be going to make the conclusion. This is our conclusion, which is given in the form of the statement, that is, by increasing the number of elements in the array, the directivity increases, that is, half power beam width decreases, that is, the half power decreases, which means the beam gets more narrow, and this will be going to give the more directivity. This is our first part conclusion. In the second part, by increasing the distance between the elements, the HPBW decreases, which means the beam gets more narrower, and this is going to increase the directivity. So this is how we have done the simulation or the experimentation on this broadside array. Actually, this is the part of the second unit. We are going to see that our first and second unit both are parallel to each other, because the antenna parameters which we are going to consider, these parameters are again coming in the second unit also. And in the second unit, we'll be going to consider the arrays of the antenna. What is basically the necessity of the antenna arrays? That when we'll be going to use the single element, in the single element, will not be getting the more directivity. We are not getting the proper directivity. For the long distance communication, the more directivity is required, means the radiation pattern should be more narrow. So in order to achieve this one, we are going to connect the number of the elements of the antenna in a parallel form or in any other form, from which we'll be going to get the more directivity. So that is what the use of the antenna arrays. And with this antenna array, that is the antenna array which we have considered, it is the broadside array. And in this broadside array, the number of the antennas, that is single element antennas, they are connected in parallel. And by varying the distance between these elements, or by varying the number of elements in this antenna array, we can control the directivity, or we can improve the directivity of this antenna. So this is in short about this experimentation, and this is the one of the experiment in your practical also.